Hello, this is Brian, and today we are doing the Beyond Labs lab called Identification of Cations in Solution, Cobalt, Chromium, and Copper. So I've already opened Beyond Labs, and I'm here at the virtual chem lab. I'm going over to descriptive chemistry. Scroll down, let's see, let's look for the right lab here. Cobalt, chromium, copper. This is one. So I'm opening it up. I'm going to grab a test tube, put it here in the metal test tube stand. And as you can see, once you got a test tube there, everything is awake and activated here. And as it says on your worksheet, I'm going to put in the cobalt 2 plus, chromium 3 plus, copper 2 plus. As you see over in this area, we have the zoom in view. You can see what the solution looks like. And since this is a known solution, it tells us exactly what is in there, the three things that we just put in the test tube. Just clicking on them fills it. You don't have to drag it over or anything like that. Before I go on, I want to duplicate what we have here in the test tube. So I'm going over here to the divide function, and as you can see, it makes appear right here a duplication of our original. This is just in case we make a mistake or otherwise want to work on the same sample we have here. Now, if you have a table of solubility rules with you, this lab will make a lot more sense. You can see on the table what you might want to add to your test tube to help you identify and separate the ions in the solution. So I'm going to try some procedures now. Over here on, this is called the reagent shelf over here, I'm going to click on the sodium hydroxide. Actually, before I do that, take a look here. So we see our solution as it is, and it tells us what ions are. Watch, it changes. As soon as I click the sodium hydroxide, it will it'll be added into there, and you will see a change right there. I hope you saw that. It went from a clear solution to a cloudy solution, and this tells us what we have. So we have two precipitates, the copper and the cobalt hydroxides, and we have two soluble ions, sodium and this complex chromium ion. So we've started to separate our ions. We're going to continue that. I'm going to click centrifuge. Oh yeah, you don't have to drag this over. It doesn't actually drag in there. It'll never land in there. You just click the centrifuge and it immediately spins it. And there you go. I hope you were looking right up there. It spun it down, precipitate at the bottom, nice clear soluble solution on top. And I'm going to go over to the decant. And after a slight delay, it puts the decanted solution here. And left in here is the precipitate, along with some water that it always adds every time you click that decant function. Now you can see over here in the screen, we still have our two insoluble precipitates, cobalt, copper hydroxides. And over here, if I mouse over this, it changes the screen over here. So keep your eye over there. As I mouse over, we see that we've got this complex chromium ion, as well as the bystander sodium ion, and a nice clear greenish solution. That, by the way, that's the test for chromium, the clear green color. We can confirm that. Let's move this out to our test tube rack for a minute. Put this, and it clicks right into place there. To confirm chromium, we're going to do a test. Keep your eye on here. I'm going over here to the pH 10. I'm going to click it. It'll immediately go into the test tube. And look at that. So we've got a black, dark, cloudy precipitate there. That is evidence that chromium is present. And we're going to do a further confirmation of that. I'm going over to the reagent shelf again. I'm going to go to the nitric acid. I'm going to click that. Watch the zoom screen. And look at that. We have a clear purple solution. And that shows us that chromium is present. That's it for that test tube. I'm going to drag it out of the way here, back into our rack, and we're going back to our first test tube, the one with the two precipitates, cobalt hydroxide, copper hydroxide. We're going to do another test. So over here, I'm going to click the ammonia. Keep your eye up over here. Let's see what happens. We immediately have a change. We can see that our solution just went cloudy again, so we have a precipitate. That's still there, the copper hydroxide. And we can see that we have a soluble ion, this tetraamine copper 2 ion right there. So we can separate these two ions out now. I'm going to click the centrifuge, watch the screen again, and we see a big change right there, this nice blue solution on top of a precipitate. I'm going to do our usual, the decant. And there it goes. We have over here, as I mouse over it, we can see the copper, the complex copper ion. And in here, we have the cobalt precipitate at the bottom with some water on top. Now I'm going to do a further test to our precipitate solution in the test tube stand. I'm going to go back over here to the HNO3 again. You can take a look there to see what happens. Clicking it, and there we go. We have an immediate change. You can see the cobalt ion is free here, but even if it didn't say here on the screen, like if this were a practice or a real unknown, this screen wouldn't tell us what's in there. But you can see by this pink solution, this clear solution, that we have cobalt. That's the confirmatory test for the cobalt ion. We're done with this test tube, so I'll put it aside here. And we're going to get this test tube that we're working on a minute ago. I'm going to put this back in the test tube stand. Now we're going to do a test on this. We are going to add some more nitric acid. Before I do that, you can see up here we've got this deep blue copper amine complex ion in solution there. Let's see what happens when we add this. I'm clicking on the nitric. Oh, wow. Okay, so big change right away there. Now we have this kind of light blue, baby blue solution, and that shows the copper ion. That is the confirmatory test for copper. Okay, so we are done with this part of the lab, the known section. We have ways to separate out and confirm all these ions. Now we're going to go and do a practice unknown. That would be step 8 on your worksheet. First, I'm going to clear out this lab. Just clicking on the red can clears everything away. And I'm coming over here where it says unknowns, and I'm clicking the unknown label. Now we're creating a practice unknown with the same ion. So I'm again, as we did at the beginning, I'm again clicking on the cobalt, chromium, copper. And you can see over here, this controls the practice unknown. I'm setting the minimum to 0. Meaning our practice unknown could have none of those ions in it. Maximum to 3. So it could have all 3 ions, 2 of them, just 1 of them, or none of them, just water. And I'm clicking way up here, it's hard to see, create unknown. And right over here, you may not have seen it, but immediately it creates a practice unknown for us. I'll just drag that over to our working area, to our test tube rack. You can see on the Zoom screen, it says practice unknown. Now, if you place your test tube in the working area, the unknown, you can do all the similar or same kind of tests that I did earlier. I'm not going to repeat them now, but you can test to check for those, which of those ions are present in your solution. And when you're done with that, you can check your results. Just go over here to the lab book where it says open lab book, clicking on that, click the report button right down here, and you select the ions that you think are in that test tube based on the tests that you did. So I didn't actually do the tests on this practice unknown, so I'm guessing here. But I'm just gonna click all three, see what happens. Once you've made your guess of what ions are in there, like I just did, hit the submit button and it will give you results. Oh, look at that. They're all green. That means I guessed right. It just turned out that the practice unknown had all the ions present. If one of them was not present and I'd guess that it was, there one the that button would be red and that would tell you your result. That is, the red would indicate that I got that wrong on that ion. It's also red if you don't guess an ion and it actually is present. Okay, I'm done with that. Click over here, the lab book goes away. And I'm gonna click the red disposal bucket to clear the lab away. And notice what happens right away, a new unknown, a new practice unknown is created just to the same parameters as the previous one. That is, it could have 0 to 3 of those same 3 ions in it. In this way, you could do as many practice unknowns as you want until you guess them right each time. Not really a guess, hopefully you're not guessing, but when you have it down, when you feel you have a grip on it, you can go on to your next part, which is the actual unknown or assigned unknown, as they call it in the last step, step 10 on your worksheet. So to do your real or assigned unknown, I'm gonna again click the red bucket. And I'm going to click the clipboard over here. So I'm going to choose basic knowns and unknowns. And I'm looking for transition metal 1 unknown. There we go. Clicking on that. And just like with the practice unknowns, we have an unknown over here. Let's grab it and put it over in our test tube rack. Might as well click the divide button. You can see this says unknown. You see it says unknown number 10. So that's what you would turn into your instructor, along with which ions you think are there. Now mine says unknown number 10 on my computer. On your computer, it'll probably be a different unknown number than that. Again, your unknown will contain the same ions as the practice unknowns did. Cobalt, chromium, copper, any 1, 2, or 3, or none of those. And you test it in the same way, of course. And that's it. Good luck.